I have found one, and they have the longest vertebra in all the world. That everybody, well, not all the world, but certainly in Africa. That everybody, of course, is a giraffe. And I'm sure many of you have seen giraffe before. Perhaps you've seen them at the zoo. And perhaps some of you have even been lucky enough to come on safari, and you maybe have seen them out here. And that is a big bull giraffe. Now, often people say, why do you call that animal a bull? Because people often think that cattle, are bulls only. But you know, there are lots and lots of male animals that are called bulls. A giraffe is no different. A buffalo is the same. And you know, even a whale is known as a bull if it's a male whale. And so we call a male giraffe a bull and a female giraffe a cow. And on top of his head, if we go in on his head, there's a very special bird there. And that special bird is called an oxpecker. Now the oxpecker is a special bird because it manages to eat the ticks that live on top of the giraffe. Now, I don't know if you in the United States there in Indiana get ticks, but I think you probably do. I'm not sure if any of you have ever seen one. But they give you a disease in the States called Lyme's disease, and that can be a very unpleasant experience. And, well, while the giraffes don't get Lyme's disease, they can get sick from too many tick bites. And so what that bird does is really help the giraffe to stay away or to remain healthy, even though there are hundreds of ticks sitting on his body trying to suck his blood. Isn't he magnificent? Now, how tall do you think he is? Well, he is about 4.5 meters tall. Now, 4.5 meters, if you want to work it out in feet, is 4.5 times 3.25, which is quite difficult to do in your head, but it's basically about 15 feet tall. 15 feet tall. I am about 5'8", so about, well, almost 3 times the height of me, which is really quite tall indeed. So they are very tall. It's impossible for me to show you. Now, Lanesville School, you are asking why it is that they've got long necks. Now, I want you to think about that. You're all 9 years old, plus minus, or approximately. Why do you think that an animal like that would have such tall or such a long neck? What would the point of it having a long neck be? Think carefully. What do you think that that animal would benefit? Why do you think that animal would benefit by having such a long neck? Then you've also asked why it's got spots. Well, it's got spots or markings like that, we think, to make it more difficult to see for its predators. Now, the only things out here big enough to eat a giraffe would be hyenas and lions. And we think that this giraffe is coloured the way it is so that when it walks through the thick bush, it's quite difficult for lions and hyenas to see it. But of course, you know, if you're that big, it's really difficult to hide. If you are 15 feet tall, phew, it's really very difficult to stay out of the way of lions and hyenas. But because they are so big, well, the lions and hyenas very seldom manage to catch them. And you might see that he's chewing. Can you see that he's chewing? And I bet you're wondering to yourself, why on earth is he chewing when he's not actually eating anything? Can you see that? Why would he be chewing something? Well, the answer is that he is like a cow. You know that a cow, a dairy cow or any cattle, will have to, they're what we call ruminants, and so they eat their leaves and their grass, and then they swallow them, and then when the first part of the stomach is full, they vomit that food back up into their mouths and they re-chew it. So that's what he's doing there. He's re-chewing his food to make it very, very small and finely chewed so that when it goes into the rest of the stomach, he can get all the goodness out of it. He can get all the nutrients. And you know, unlike us, you know, we eat meat and we eat grains sometimes and we eat fat and we eat butter and we eat meat and we eat salads and fruit, so we have lots of different things in our diet. Something like a giraffe has only got really a few kinds of leaves to eat, and so that means that he has to use his food very carefully. And the one way to do that is to chew his food very extensively until it is tiny, tiny little pieces, because that really helps him to digest his food effectively. There we go, Lachlan, you're in Lanesburg, and you, or Lanesville, and you say that the reason that a giraffe is so tall is that its neck is needed to reach the tall parts of the trees, and you're absolutely correct. That's exactly why they've got long necks. They need to reach up into the trees. And the reason that they are like that is that they can escape having to compete with any other animals for the tops of the trees. So they've got a whole lot of food that no other animal can reach. So I think that's really clever. Right, my friend Byron, you haven't seen him yet. He is with one of the very funniest animals in the bush.